There are several ways to display a gallery of your photos or other images. The gallery block contains individual blocks for each image and arranges them in a more attractive way. To add a gallery block, click the block inserter button and then search for the gallery block. Or type a forward slash on a new line followed by the word gallery. Then press enter to add the gallery block. Next, it's time to add some images. You can upload image files from your computer or select images from your media library, your Google Photos account, or from Pexels. I'll select some images I've already uploaded to my media library. And when I've selected all the images I want to include, I'll click the button to create a new gallery. In the next step, you can drag and drop the images into a different order if you like. You can also add or edit the captions that will appear beneath each image. And you can remove images from the gallery by clicking X in the top right corner of the image. When you're happy with the images you've selected, click the button at the bottom to insert the gallery into the page. Click on the white space between the images to select the parent gallery block. And in the toolbar at the top, you can change the width and the alignment of the entire gallery, and you can add additional images if you like. Under the additional settings for the gallery block, you can choose the number of columns for the gallery's layout, and your images will automatically rearrange themselves into the best configuration for the number of columns you select. You can also select whether or not you'd like your gallery images to be cropped, which is a really useful feature if your images are of different shapes and sizes. Next, choose what you'd like to happen when a visitor clicks on one of your images. The default is none, which means nothing will happen when someone clicks an image. Media file will open the image in a full screen carousel view, which your visitors can navigate through one image at a time. If you select attachment page, the image will open on its own dedicated page, which contains the image, the caption, a description of the image, and a field for your visitors to add a comment. And last, you can choose a different image size for the thumbnails that appear within the gallery. While these settings apply to the entire gallery block, you can still edit the individual images within the gallery by simply clicking on the image you wish to edit. In the toolbar at the top of the image, you'll find the usual options to drag the image into a different location, or use the arrow buttons to move the image to the left or right. Click the link button to change what happens when a visitor clicks this particular image. You can paste a URL to create a link, or link to a published page on your site, or you can override the default settings for the entire gallery block and display this image as a media file or on its own attachment page. Click the crop icon and you can change the zoom, select a different aspect ratio, rotate the image, and then reposition the image within the new cropped area. When you're happy with your changes, click the apply button. If you want to get a little more creative, you can apply a special effect called a duotone to the image. To create this effect, choose one of the preset color combinations or select your own colors for the shadows and the highlights. To remove the effect, click the clear button. And of course, you can also replace any image in the gallery anytime you like. In the settings panel on the right, you can choose between rounded or the default style for the frame. You can also edit the alternative text description for the image, which not only gives search engines an idea of what your images are, but also helps your visually impaired users to know what each image represents. Once again, you can select a different image size to use for the thumbnail. And finally, you can round the corners of an image by entering a number in the radius field. The gallery block is a beautiful way to display your images, but there are a couple of other ways to display those images. Click the white space between the images to select the parent gallery block. Then click the button to the left to transform the entire block into a tiled gallery. With the tiled gallery block, you can display your image galleries in four different styles. The tiled mosaic is the default layout you see here, but you can also choose circles, square tiles, or a tiled column. In the toolbar, you'll also find a handful of image filters you can apply to all of the images in your tiled gallery. Click the button on the left of the toolbar and you can transform the entire gallery into a slideshow block. And this is what it looks like when added to a page. In the settings, you can enable autoplay to have your slideshow automatically move between images. And you can choose how long you'd like each slide to display before it changes. You can also choose between two different transition effects, slide or fade. Whether you choose the slideshow block, a tiled gallery, or the regular gallery block, you'll be able to create beautiful photo galleries your visitors will love. For more help creating image galleries for your website, please visit WordPress.com/support.